next day, the nurse's office. Oh, you're awake. Hey, you okay? How many fingers am I holding up? The McGonagall recognized conscience, he was greeted by the sound of a fingers around his long, fake nails being fake faces in his face. You're Junko, right? Hey, you do sound so unsure. Why do you sound so unsure? It's a little shocked to hear you say that. I'm really shocked to hear you say that. Despite what she said, Junko Nishima, l'ultima fascinista, was laughing as she found out she found this all very amusing. I got a look around and realized he had never seen this place before. Looks somewhat like an hospital. Three beds, including his own, were reclining in his room. The various medical instruments laid strewn around them. The black shiny left surgery a person, but as he set up, Macross man immediately created one possibility. Where were we? Did we get rescued? That'd be nice, huh? She passed the sheer locked away. Junko explained that he was in the nurse's office on the first floor of the academy. Tomorrow, Ding said, I can't bear to see my precious students get sick and open this place up this morning. Would you think it's suspicious? What do you feel all this in money instead of poisons? Poison? To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised. Forgot to remember his encoded with the escape button and let out the smaller side. Ah, so why am I here, Junko? You should thank Saka for that. She was here the whole night taking care of you. She was? Junko ignored Magoro's surprise and continued casually talking. But then Saka got all fried up and was like, we should take turns watching over him. Of course, Taka said that. Not surprised. I just wanted to be on duty when you woke up. Well, even then, it's only because Byakko bitched. Of course. I see. Thanks. Like I said, you should thanks, Sayaka. Anyway, how are you feeling? Is everything alright? I got to talk about you for a moment. I remember what he had been thinking about just before he lost consciousness. It's kind of weird, but. Actually, it's really weird that question, but what's up? Junko, you never meet each other before, right? Oh, le question. Avoiding this, Junko says she wanted. By a few seconds later, she began aloud to laugh. Huh? You for real? The pickup line is like so totally played out, you know? In that she was bringing a serious look over her face. Just you know, you shouldn't say anything like that for me. I know I look this way, but I take my virtue pretty seriously. Oh no, I mean, I never expected. Well, that's what I figured it's obviously. But that's what I figured. It's obvious that you're out of the whole mega man anyway. Well, then Junko continued to talk to one another. Although he would never wait where Junko was taken to him instead of leaving to go to the others, Makoto didn't question it. I just want to talk to someone, anyone. So long as I see them interact with his fellow students, he believed he would learn the truth about what was going on inside his head. 10 minutes later. Junko mostly talk about alpha males and omega males, her time being ominous, and about her past and her dreams for the future. The last topic was a lot different than the previous ones, but Makoto's calm and environment seems to cheer up. She seems sensitive and said also softly, thanks, Makoto. Maybe it was a sign of a creature for listening to her trouble, but she kept it in the same this manner as if she brought it to Austin horrifying. You don't promise that if you do decide to kill someone, it won't bite you. It won't be you. Okay. Don't say such scary stuff like that. At least that's what Makoto thought. But the words that come out of this most convenient different system. I see. Thanks. But we don't want you to become a black alien in the first place. For some reason, Makoto feels like the murderous word that come out of Jung's mouth seems like a natural thing for her to say. She seemed very surprised by Makoto's response and quietly blown out. Huh? Are you serious? I was just kidding. Huh? Oh yeah, of course. So the fucking is so weird. No worries. Let's just chat this up to you. Let's crack this up to you being woozy from your recovery. You don't know to rest with your ball yourself. Let the big stretch and it's on Makoto. I'm gonna get going now. Make sure you don't get killed before the next person arrives. At the scene of her off, Makoto laid back down in the bed and started thinking of to himself. What is this strange thing? His door and the car continued to search and began to bowl. I was just that to care to Junko, but I feel like I was talking to someone else. Who is she? The more he thought, the more he felt like his memories were shaking to the thick swaps. Each throw of pain and bruising his head left like a wall on his face and on the swamp. What is this feeling? It feels very unpleasant, as I thought someone's voice was screaming at him from inside his head. Makoto tried to recognize his thought and go over everything that happened to him. But he wasn't interrupted by the sounds of a bell. Like the dorm rooms, the nurse office didn't have a doorbell. The best sounds that Makoto heard was ringing through the entire building. Testing, match check, 1, 2, is the test of school progress system. Okay, this is Monokuma. It was Monokuma's voice. No doubt about my color was when I woke up, please assemble at the gym. My color is to Makuno's address order and go out of the bed without complaining. Okay, to go. You walk out to this odon on step at a time. Nakonin with the deductive rhythm as if troubling Hecate. Slowly work forward. No knew where he was said was heaven or hell. Who knows? The gym. Makoto, are you alright? Seika ran over to Makoto as soon as she entered the room, obviously. Yeah, thanks. Sorry about yesterday. I guess I really worried about you. You don't apologize, and sorry too. I brought you into your room when you weren't feeling well. Not that you mention it, said Makoto. What happened yesterday? Seika looked away from the brief moment, but immediately turned back, smiled for a pop sensual smile, and shook her head. Ah, it's nothing. I'll tell you some other time. Why is the impression that Makoto was sick the weekend that Saga didn't do her plan on trying to kill Leon? Wonder. Huh? While they were talking, Kyotaka Shima resulted in a moral compass. Stafford pointed an accusing finger on Makoto. Obviously. You're late, Makoto. Explain why you were tardy. Come on, Kyotaka, you know why. The other students collected the rest of their eyebrows, as if they were thinking, what is this guy yelling at someone who was sick? Well, it was Makoto, or it's Taka, so no surprise. I read my clothes just imaginedly and answered him honestly. It didn't feel so well, so I was resting in the nurse's office. Can you note that in the logbook? I see. That's consistent with my information. If that's the case, then I should consider this matter settled. Okay, Taka. The essential progressed smoothly, and Taka smiled as he kept talking. Ha ha ha. I take full responsibility for recovering it. You just focus on recovering the community. If you ever fall ill, please report to the health committee. Okay. It seems we need to appoint all the committee members after this meeting, though. Taka walked away, mumbling to himself as he opened the deal book he found in the academy's supply room. Of course he found it. Again, not surprised. Just with Bang, the ultimate gambler, who saw the whole conversation and walked up to Makoto. Despite his nervous behavior, you knew exactly what to say to him. Huh? As soon as Rest said that, he downed on Makoto. It's true that he didn't feel well and that he had been resting to the nurse's office. But when Taka asked him why he was late, even though he shouldn't already know the reason, Makoto didn't feel annoyed or disappointed about it. He was like if he expected Taka to say that. Makoto felt strange that he had expected Taka's personality so quickly. He couldn't understand why he asked Taka to do something so as necessary as recovering it in the logbook in the first place. Why did I say that? Is it like I was used to it? Response to Taka's demand comes essentially to him as a breathing. Why? The time he tried to think about it, his fear grew even worse. As Makoto started to think through the pain as he was like it. Manu come up here. A black and white helmet jumped out from behind the gym's brawn and began running around as if he spoke of cheerful voice. Hey guys, is Savannah here? It sounds like he was about to lead the students on a field trip, but not a single one of them had the same smile on their faces, obviously. What is this time? Are you going to a cruise ship and run into a giant worm? Of course there was one expression. Inspection. You still get a calculate the ultimate cleverant, still believe that the correct situation was some kind of plan event. Obviously. Makoma just ignored him and continued to address this sentence with this adorable voice. Today is going to tell you about our wonderful academy system. System sure sounds like a great word, don't you think? Look at that danger, just like a bear. When you are to a temple of the deaths of your friends and group of the weapon under their hearts. It's going to be a little nasty. They want you all to grow poison and personalities. To make Kina's easy non-necessary introduction, Makoma moved to the next topic. With this, he began providing a detailed explanation of the most valuable system in the school. The castle. Nah, you can't just kill someone. You're gonna kill someone without even eyes to find out you did it. Makoma felt thinking about his horrible graduation program with casual indifference. But because of killing hadn't happened yet, his lecture didn't see any display in the students. As long as the killing never occurred, there'd be no point of the castle. But non could really say that killing wasn't going to happen. The students' suspicion began to rise, Makoma continued explaining the class child until... Wait, hold on a second. As Makoma began explaining the execution, the world was served as punishment on good step forward. Junko. As soon as he saw how angry she was, the tone of Makoto's tennis began to change suddenly. You're freaking insane, you know that? Hmm? The girl continued to complain angrily. She seemed completely different from this demanding person Makoto saw in the nurse's office. Huh? Did Junko always say like that? No, she's different. That's how Junko can act, but... Is that person really Junko? Huh? Really, what am I thinking? As Makoto struggled with his anger and confusion, Murakumo and the girl continued to argue. What? Are you saying you're not gonna predict Charles? When you punishment with such a blasphemy? What? Punishment? I might, I don't know, throw you in a deep, dark, scary prison or something. Different. I seem to be feeling that the field was no different than Murakumo. A prison? No, they aren't that kind. She seems to have a much flash in Makoto's mind. In the first day, he thought it was some kind of parade. But he quickly realized that was a mistake. What looked like lights were actually pulling green flames. The red colored this scene seemed to have one come from a human's bodies. Despair. He wasn't confined to the academy or even to Japan. Imagine a warning with death and the discussion of food, Makoto's brain with every brown with secrets. Has they ever seen this before? Besides the incredible violence taking place in these old images, there was one thing they had in common. Who are they? They are... The main authorities wearing black and white masks were wearing a walk in these images. They took everything, money, bubbles, lives, families, dignity, the past, the future, and possibly even hope. The mask these stories were wearing perfectly and the most resemblant the fact that the face of the severe animals are grieving with the historians before him. Shut it up, say whatever you want, I'm not gonna be part of this. Don't be so selfish. You're the one with the selfish. Kill whatever you want is gonna have nothing to do with me. It's even standing here before me. And everybody with fear. They won't give in on such evil. It's my style of striking out and rest till the very end. If you really wanna get out there, you'll have to go through to me first. Murakumo swung his arms when he was charged at the girl with the warning steps. But the girl stopped on all the self-reflection and the master of the academy with delight. Gah! You're doing yourself now. Pinning the girl's foot, Murakumo looked up into the girl's look eyes and calmly asked, are you? Huh? Violence against the master is not allowed. You want a school regression. The moment a chair ran down Makoto's spine, she could get killed. Makoto swore the sound very tremulous to him. He wasn't a predicator or a guest. I guess it was as if he knew the danger Makoto posed from the start. He discontinued, Junko's going to. His mind stayed in a full grip of the situation in front of him. By the time of the regions, he was about to remember something he was already running toward. Junko? The impact of his feet combined with the rim of his head, sending his brain and heart into panic. No, she's different. She's... I invoked the night some spell. Help to me, glorious spirit, grinning. Makoto ran in the girl's foot and let out a scream. At the next It's a moment I'm going to charge ya, didn't scream out. Mukura, watch out! Huh? The girl dressed as Junko no Shima went her eyes in shock. Decided to wear the Genji Makoto, she jumped back with a cheated children of a teenage school girl. And then... At that moment, Kuno praised the spot where she had been standing just by a second ago. All the students, including the girl, studied with eyes the situation to no event. Spears, too many of them to count, are shot out with a burning spinner from a machine in the floor at the waist of the gym. However, Makoto was unable to notice this. Huh? Why? Did call Junko Mukuro? Mukuro? That thought was even in his mind, a sharp stone and spike struck his side. Oh, fuck. Further by an intense, deadly pain to run down his spine and spin through his entire body. Fuck. He gets stabbed instead of Junko. I mean Mukuro. Fuck. His fist came to his side, he sent it to his vest to research and shot out his back. Found the blood and other spot his words. Fuck. At the moment he black fog that had looked Makoto's money was convinced by itself. And as if conscious, slowly heeded he remains and everything. Because of the electric loss and the genical commands from an escape button, because of the button that he had found by chance. But Makoto never managed to escape. Escaping his old place game where he had his fellow students had the memory stolen, and were forced to kill each other. Of course, the escape is also what led into his which life for death predicament. In the end, perhaps the only escape from this despair to fall into another. But at this same time, his action are intimately connected from one person. The girl living at first in the idea is her beloved sister Junko Noshima. Buki Kusaba, the ultimate soldier and a member of the ultimate despair. Her past, her future, perhaps even her hope itself, are the path to despair. And so the curtain falls on my girl's story for now. From this point, this story starts about to send a girl. A girl who more beautiful than anyone else is my Hellfoss Academy. A new container along with a new despair as shall not rise.